Waterford, Virginia, 2013. Sidonia Institute researcher George Haas is combing through images of Mars when something catches his eye. A large formation protruding from the surface of the planet that displays extraordinary symmetry. He is struck by the fact that there are no other large geographical features around it, and it has the distinct shape of a keyhole.
When you initially look at it, it looks like something that someone made. So when scientists are looking for signs of activity on another planet, they're looking for structural symmetry, determining if this is possibly just something nature made or something that humans or extraterrestrials had a hand in. What we're seeing on Mars could be evidence of intelligent design by some unknown extraterrestrial culture.
The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter took amazing detailed maps of pretty much the whole surface of Mars. And there are some anomalous pictures. It's very much worth humanity's while to travel there and find out for sure, are these artificial or not?
Could it be that this strangely symmetrical formation on Mars is really an artificial structure built by an extraterrestrial race? For ancient astronaut theorists, what makes this image even more intriguing is the fact that strikingly similar man-made structures exist here on Earth. Osaka, Japan. Today, this bustling metropolis is famous as one of Japan's cultural centers of food, fashion, and finance. But in its southern suburb of Sakai lies an ancient and mysterious monument, a megalithic tomb called Daisen Kofun.
It rises up 35 feet above the surrounding area and is 1,600 feet long and 980 feet wide. And it's encircled by three moats, making the entire edifice cover a space of 5 million square feet.
You can only really appreciate what it represents by going up into the air and looking down on it, because you then see that it's an enormous keyhole shape.
The Daisen Kofun is merely the largest of more than 160,000 kofuns that dot Japan.
There are hundreds of these tombs built between around 300 AD to around 600 AD, all over Japan. So what were these? Were these really just tombs built for emperors and kings, or were they something else altogether?
The keyhole shape can only be seen from the air. And we're told that the ancient Japanese did not have a means of getting into the sky to appreciate this shape. So there's a great mystery here about why the keyhole shape.
Some researchers suggest that the purpose of the keyhole shape can be traced back to the first kofun ever built.
The first of these tombs is associated with the first historical Japanese emperor, Emperor Sujin, in whose record in the book of ancient mythology, the Kojiki, a keyhole of a door actually also plays an important part.
According to the story in the Kojiki, a young woman becomes impregnated by a powerful god who comes to a room through a keyhole, then gives birth to semi-divine children. Another story from the same texts tells that the Japanese royal family are all descendants of Amaterasu, who came from the celestial plane.
So, what's the deal here? Why do we have these stories of someone coming from the sky? They also describe them as having come down from their celestial palace, which is called Takamagahara. It's right there. Our ancestors did not have words for extraterrestrials or aliens or any other creature coming from another planet because it didn't exist at the time.
So you've got to wonder if these keyhole-shaped kofun aren't something that were actually designed by extraterrestrials. There's something about that shape. It has meaning. are these sites signaling somebody who is apparently in the sky?